Yeah, it was my first trip to Indonesia and my first trip overseas with Birch and Whip, so caught the next ferry over to deserts. We were confronted by a man who spoke pretty fluent English, and he was telling us that we shouldn't drive the truck at night. People have been taken and like robbed and killed and all sorts of crazy shit, so
it's bad.
We decided that we were going to risk it and go straight to deserts, and the fact that our taxi driver had a metal bat, a gun and handcuffs in his glove box, so we thought we were in pretty safe hands. Started driving the track, dudes on motorbikes were coming up beside us looking into the car. My heart was beating the fastest it's ever beated in my life, I reckon. It was one of the scariest moments I've ever been in. Yeah, we eventually got to deserts and it was probably the coolest setup in the world. Yeah, it was an amazing experience and I was so stoked to go overseas and meet new people and surf some of the best waves I've ever surfed in my life. So yeah, overall, amazing trip.
So we were just cruising in Byron, having fun, and then we decided to go down to Tranquil South Coast to meet up with Bircher and Kingy. And I bought a porno mag from the late 80s out of some shop that sells $2 jaffles. And on the way we got a train. The train ride was pretty sick, but a little bit sketchy. We spent a bit of time at night in the station, which was kind of weird. And then we used to chill down there for 4 days and pretty much just drank heaps of beer and went surfing.
We'll be right back.
Shut up. How's your leggy?
Good luck in the world,
Jacob. Yeah,
okay.
Nice to meet
you, mate. Yeah, nice. Yeah.
It was looking pretty good this time. We'd been there a few times earlier on the year. It'd been too big, and then one time we went down, the car broke down. We had to get a tow back, and then we missed the swell. But that's just part of chasing these swells. We're all pretty nervous and psyched at the same time. It's kind of that wave that you go down there, and you're just sort of hunting that one wave anyway. It's all you need is that one big barrel out there, and it makes it all worthwhile.
After the trip to that left, we were back on the road for another four straight days of driving. Things can get quite weird out there. The most exciting thing in the day is probably rocking up at a servo. Me and Whit were both itching to surf this right that we'd heard about that was breaking in the middle of nowhere. The whole drive was kind of anxious because you had a rough idea of where you wanted to surf, but you weren't sure if you were actually going to find it. We took a few wrong turns, but after the 4 day drive, we got to this last bit of road that we'd heard about that the car might not make it through. So it felt good just to get out and stretch the legs, and we started sprinting towards what we hoped would be the wave around the corner. Turns out it was, and we found it, and we were so stoked to find it. It was the best feeling.
Strangers warn, don't be trapped by the angry storm. Suitcase, fix my head. Damn my dreams before they're dead. Ay, ay, ay. Ay, ay, ay. Ay, ay. On the night line. On the night line. Numb your life, make your days before your time. As the Greek was scorned, staring to the poison sores. Footsteps, footsteps, with all in the face. Footsteps, footsteps, fading away.
Because Marshy rocked up at the end of the trip. He had $5 to his name, like when we pulled up in my driveway. So I could say this was the kind of scrape in the barrel trip. When we arrived home from this trip, Marshy had $5 or something. Oh, is that good? I don't know. Because that, otherwise, yeah, what else? Otherwise, what else do I talk about, really? Like, we just hung and got shit waves. Ended up bumping into a guy and having a quick combo, and he'd just been working on Wolf Creek 2 and he was pretty pumped on that. And
just finished filming Wolf Creek 2.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, for Wolf Creek.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Sick.
Just finished 2 weeks ago.
And then we went down and met up with my mate Jarrah from home, and it was actually really intense walk in. There's big high sand dunes, and never thought it would have been that hard to walk in because you're kind of fatigued by the time you get there. Looking at the wave from eye level was kind of confronting because it just looks like unpaddleable, and I was kind of like, oh, what have I got myself into here? But luckily Jarrah had been there a few times and he was just said, oh, let's get out there, it looks good, let's get straight into it, and turned into a pretty sick day.
Yeah.
I think Slater had a GPS on our car because he was at that crazy right in the middle of nowhere, and then here he was again at Shippy's. Yeah, it's good, son.
Yeah, it's good.
So at the end of the trip, we were heading back to the airport, pretty pumped on everything we'd seen and done. And yeah, we were kind of taking in all the Tassie scenery and how nice it was. And then all of a sudden, the trees cleared and here we were at this rally track. Everyone was there just doing burnouts and drinking rum. And yeah, it was a sorry sight. We got out of the car and we were all just losing it. It was pouring down rain there for a while and there was still a big crowd in watching everyone smoke it up. Yeah, we ended up getting out of there, but it was pretty funny to see. After a year of travelling around and surfing all these sick locations, nothing beats coming home and hanging out with your mates and surfing with all the familiar faces and just having a good time.